Look at
I
him.
Was just like, man.
Man, I caught a lot of shit down there.
I know, you did catch a lot of stuff down there. It was crazy. I couldn't believe it. I was like, yo, you up there posting the finds from the thrift store out in Virginia Beach, and I'm looking through every record that you
know, it was actually,
and I'm like,
it was a Goodwill right outside of right outside of Fredericksburg.
Right outside
of
Fredericksburg. Oh, look at that, see? Yeah, I was a little salty, I'm not gonna lie.
And you know, I talked to Pete Twist, and that Goodyear, that Goodwill is like 5 minutes from his crib, and he never goes in there.
See, bad move.
Snooze, you lose.
And there you go. So yeah, I was a little salty, I'm not gonna lie.
But you have all those records.
No, I have all the records. Yeah, I can't lie. I got all the records. It was just the fact that you got them for the low low.
Oh yeah.
The low low. That's what I was salty about. I was like, did he just pull Roy Harris from Goodwill? I know he only paid like nothing more than $2 for it.
And did you listen to the story about the dude that was already in there?
Yeah, that was a crazy story, yo.
Man, he talking about, some dude just copped all the good records. Like, he got all the good Funkadelic. I was like, what? Man, are you crazy?
You all see the good Funkadelic.
Right.
You see what I got in my hand?
All he wanted was a Star Wars soundtrack. I'm like, thank God. Hey, get out of my way. Yeah. Keep fucking with Star Wars soundtracks.
Right, so I'm gonna play this joint here. This is Howard Roberts, Antelope Freeway. So some joint that I just got out this weekend when I was out in Charlotte, visiting my peeps, Pops for Father's Day. So stopped at a spot out there called Manifest. If anybody's in the Charlotte area, you know about Manifest. If you're not in the Charlotte area and you happen to be passing through
Charlotte, North Carolina?
Charlotte, North Carolina, baby.
Okay,
sorry.
Let's
make that clear. Charlotte, yeah. North Carolina. You happen to be passing through, you got some time to spend. Manifest in Charlotte, North Carolina. I know I'm doing a plug and I'm probably not going to get any type of sponsorship or residuals from it, but
hell no.
I'm still plugging it. That's where I went record shopping this weekend. So. All
right. I went record shopping at the Goodwill.
Yeah, we know. You don't got to keep rubbing it in, Gadget. I'm gotta keep rubbing it in. Alright, so.
Turn it up a little bit. Oh, yeah.
Should be coming up.
Shit, I would've used that.
Right here.
Until just a few minutes ago.
It's from the Beats, Rhymes, and Life Tribe Called Quest album. It's the song Keep It Moving. Obviously, they did a really good job on chopping it, bouncing it, you know, and kind of grabbing a little bit more of hits versus taking the long extended part. So,
To be fair, I didn't really listen to that album too much.
I did.
I wasn't a big fan of that album.
There were joints on there. I'm not going to say it was my favorite album, but there were certain joints on there that I really did like just because...
Was that one of the particular ones?
Yes, just one of the particular ones that I liked. I thought that was dope, so I can't front. So definitely was on that particular one. I always liked the way the guitars work.
Man, Tribe was always, like, hit or miss with me with songs. Like, first three albums to me were dope, but everything after that, it was like, okay, these two songs are really dope. These three songs aren't.
So, Howard Roberts, everybody.
Yeah.
I'm going to pull out some other joints for you. I know I kind of just snatched joints up on the random. Thrift store.
How much did you pay for that record?
I got it for a good price. I'm not going to lie. I paid $15 for it, which I think is an awesome price compared to...
$15.
But, you know, compared to what you paid for it,
I paid 60 cents.
Yeah, exactly. See, once again, throwing salt in the wounds.
Yeah.
Anybody who's familiar with this record, then you already know what's on it before I even hit play.
Big shout out to all the Goodwills on.
But you know what? I just found out the other day, listening to Kendrick, that there's another sample that was used on here.
Besides Kendrick Lamar?
Yeah.
We're not going to play that so he gets Lamar sued. We're going to play the sample that he did clear.
The other sample is not what he cleared. I'm not trying to have another Tribe episode here with the scenario. Me not being able to find a sample.
Right. But it looks like that's what's about to happen.
Looks like it, right?
I feel somebody sampled that before. What album was that on?
Street Level.
Okay.
Yeah. So. That is the Beat Nuts. We're not going to play the Kendrick joint.
Yeah, don't play the Kendrick joint. I ain't trying to get nobody sued.
Leave it alone.
Right.
But there is something but
just
on here.
Yeah, just say it's on there.
It's on here. I'm not going to tell you what it is. We're going to leave it alone.
Now ASCAP gonna be fucking combing through the record because of your ass.
Hey, look, I just kind of put it out there. I'm not telling you what it is, though. The remix, did we go through that last time?
I don't know.
Yeah, I think we did.
Ciroc's 2500 done been through some wars.
Yeah, they've been
jumping. Damn.
Been through something crucial. Basically,
but he got some funky shit coming up out of here, though.
Oh, yeah. No doubt. And
all the 66, man.
All right, so Jimmy Ponder, Gently My Guitar Weeps. Great album. A few things on here that we used. I'm going to touch on one of them, so. But there's a few joints on here, but.
Well, this video is full of pauses. Go ahead, man.
Right.
You went from I'm gonna pull a joint out to we're gonna touch on some things. Boy.
Pause.
Boy, exactly.
Guitars at the beginning is basically what was rock before, some y'all should know. De La Joint, so.
De La Joint.
Listen to the guitars.
What De La song?
I Am Abi.
I Am what?
I Am Abi. I gotta play it for you?
Yeah. YouTube! See, I was away from hip hop for about 4 years. When Balloon Mind State and Tribe and all that came out. Like, I didn't come back into hip hop until shit. Sosa? Nah.
Where the fuck was you at?
I was in North Dakota.
North Dakota?
Don't ask.
We're gonna leave it alone.
Yeah,
right
leave,
there.
Yeah, leave that alone.
Right there.
When now? I am Shorty. IB 411.
I am IB. I am.
I am Shorty. IB 411. Didn't make papers off Carolina. A little something like this. Look, Ma, no protection. Now I got a daughter named Ayana Monet. And I can play the cowboy to rustle in the dough. So the scenery is healthy with her eyes lay. I am an early bird, but the feathers are black. So the apples that I catch are usually all worms. But it's a must to decipher one's queen from a worm who plays blue power to run out on the best nigga shit. I guess we got our own life to live. Or is it because we want our own kingdom to rule? Every now and then I step to the now. But now I sit back in, I'm touching with her plan. And if I was a drug queen, I bet your pasta had the cleanest drugs I am. The plug tube ran with the flavor in the end, right? Was sniffing, so a sack of shows in demand. My carry is a bit, so I can play. In the flute, watch the sniffing, so a sack of shows in demand. I read the diction from the second page. I got the 1-2 gauge baritone to the infant fan. Trees fall, so I can play ground with my ink. So let me lead you to my M's go.
I've heard the song in years.
My carry is a B on my wood, so my plugins already know. Lick shots with my wool, cancel it out from a ghost in the heckling crowd. If I give a fuck,
yes, swing. That's weird.
I was just playing. You're playing the phone on you.
Yeah,
that is crazy. You were just playing that on your phone.
It's right. I mean, I'm serious.
So,
you playing the album or that's a particular song?
I was playing song. I Am IB. It's on the phone right now.
Anyway, it's a dope album in general. Aside from that one joint,
there has to be something else on that record.
It is, but
go ahead. Yeah, nah, nigga.
He's like, don't hold back.
Yeah.
Just play it. Alright, this is something Pete did a while back. I don't know, for the new folks, you may not know, but the older folks, there was a group called Adore, if I'm correct. Is that
yeah, the Puerto Rican kid.
Yeah, Puerto Rican kid, so.
Let it all hang out. Mm-hmm. He had another song besides that? Not yet.
It's pretty much all the beginning. That's all.
I have this record though. I'm gonna have to go home and break the record out.
And break it out and listen to it. Cause he put out a 12-inch and this was the flip side of the 12-inch.
But he only had that one song. So this must have been... He only had two songs.
Yeah, and this was the B-side.
Never rocked the B-side.
That's why he...
But Pete Rock did both sides, didn't he?
Yeah, he did both sides. But this is one of the ones that he did. If I'm correct, this was...
I probably did play it, but
it
just
wasn't the
remember.
Most played one, because the other one was the one that rocked out as the single that everybody was rocking. But if I'm correct, that is the B-side. So I remember hearing and finding the sample and was like, oh, like this, that.
What was that dude that had that song, This is the B-side? Was it Laquan?
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 No, now it's the B-turn.
Now it's the B-turn, yeah.
Why the fuck do I know that?
I don't know.
Yeah, hold on.
He was on Rapper.
Yeah, I think I know what's on here. See, I think I do, so don't quote me on that.
That's exactly what they did.
They locked themselves out?
Well, AJ ran out the crib to open the door for him, but then left the door locked, so they pretty much all locked themselves out.
I locked myself out, didn't I?
You did.
Yeah, when I heard the door, I was like, ouch. Let me call him.
So we rocking with this Mad Lads joint. I had to pull everything out the plastic, because it's one of them joints that kind of keep all bundled up tight because it's kind of a slightly rare record to find. So I don't play that often. So, but
we got a legend in the building, by the way.
Oh yeah, we
two legends.
Man, Rock.
A legend over there.
Oh fuck you, man! I got to work clothes. See,
we was actually running a session here before Gadget came, but you know. We taking time out to do the needle drops in between.
That's right.
And then we going back.
And Ciroc is gonna play a joint on off his 2500.
I don't know.
He don't know it.
I don't know yet. Maybe.
You can't play an instrumental?
I don't know. Maybe. Maybe.
See. Let's play with the pads.
Play with the pads. Think about it.
Pause.
Yeah.
Another pause. All right. Let's go. All right. We got any MOP fans in the house? I gotta say, this is probably one of my favorite MOP songs off of Warrior.
Our period do this?
He may have. I gotta look and check the credits. Actually, DR period from North Carolina, right? That dude from North Carolina?
I don't know. Is DR? He ain't from North Carolina, is he?
No,
he
think about DR.
He think about DR, right? Okay, that's somebody else. Okay. I got a little confused. I met another DR recently, so. Dope album.
I don't know.
Mad Lads, if you can find it. Song.
Plus, look at these other dope records that you can get the sample from. Memphis Sound.
If you can't find the album, it's actually on 45 as well. Because I do have a 45 copy of it. So, either or, LP, 45. If you can find the LP, I suggest it's a dope album in general to have. It's just real good soul stuff.
Okay.
Right. See what else we can get into over here. It's crazy busy in here. If y'all ain't noticed already,
let's talk about what you got coming out on Man Bites Dog Records.
I got the album coming out, my debut. It's called My Heart's a Metronome. It's about 90% done, so should be dropping in the fall. So. Look out for that.
That's what's up. What happened to the joint that you had with the video game beats?
Oh, Cartridge Sound?
Yeah.
I was going to shop it, man, but...
It's
all good.
I guess it got old, but there's something on there on this album dropping in the fall, so...
Okay.
But yeah, that's not happening anymore. You know, I might just put it out for free just for the hell of it, but...
But you got an Elza feature on it, right?
On My Heart's a Metronome? Yeah, it's... actually a Crooked Eye and Elzai track called Rugged Music.
Wow.
Yeah.
Crooked Eye Elzai.
Yeah, I've been sitting on it for a minute too, so it's coming though. It's definitely coming.
Okay. We're going with another classic joint here.
I know what's on here.
You know what's on here.
I already know what's on here.
You know, everybody may not know, but you know, folks that, you know, they've been digging for a minute gonna know before I even drop the needle.
What can I do?
But you know,
not even
those,
that. Yeah,
for those who don't know,
when the East is in the house, oh my God.
About to find out.
I got like 345s of that.
Oh, for that?
Not the cleanest copy, but you know, we rocking with it.
Boss. I don't really wanna be.
Play the other joint.
Play the other joint. We know. Yeah. Don't worry about it. This joint used to rock. Made you proud to be from the East Coast.
Yeah. I don't listen to this one too much when I play the album.
I think it's
like in the middle somewhere,
it's
right?
In the middle.
Yeah, that's where it's going.
PF Cutting did his thing on this record.
Alright, so you got that as well. When the East is in the house.
Where'd you pull that one?
This?
Yeah.
From my spot that I always go to. My main spot.
Oh yeah, that's right.
My main spot.
I think I pulled it in Orlando. What's that record still called in Orlando? Rock and Roll something? Rock and Roll Heaven?
That's the same place you got that Somers joint before I
came. Yeah, that's where I got the Somers joint too.
Yeah. I was highly upset. There was a record I was looking for that I found, the title of, found out it had a dope break on it. Told my man Ciroc about it. And then he goes down to Orlando, and calls me while he's in Orlando and be like, yo, Heck, I found that record. Do you realize that it took me a whole year from that time that he found the record to find the record, and I came up on it in Detroit, remember?
Mm-hmm.
Because he was in Detroit with me.
Because the cover you had originally was different, right? Because when I saw the cover, I was like, oh, Brett Somers, I was like, yo, this
what happened was somebody sent me on a wild goose chase with the cover.
Yeah, because it was a different, like that cover you showed me was something completely different. It was another record, I think.
Yeah, let me show him real quick. I think the record is down there somewhere.
Hit some pads, man. Let's see what you got.
So this the record right here that I was looking for.
That was it, man.
That he found in Orlando a year prior to me finding my copy.
What's on that?
It's a drum break.
Oh, man.
Killer drum break. And to be honest with
you, I'm about to have a treat, man.
Should have brought my thumb drive with me.
I shouldn't have brought this one up, man.
Should have got my thumb drive. Let me get my thumb drive.
You know it got used, right?
Who flipped it again?
It got used on the Action joint, that Rare Chandeliers joint.
Action Bronson?
What song? You remember what song it was? You remember what song? No?
One of the Posse Cuts.
Oh, was it the one with Sean P, maybe?
I have to go back and listen.
Alchemist did it?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. He did every joint except for one.
Yep. Oh, I know his song.
That was it.
He was from the beginning, too.
Break is killer.
See how we do? See how we bring the knowledge? That's crazy.
That break is killer.
Then it goes into some old polka music.
People even know about that one like that.
I heard about this for the first time, yo, I went bananas. It's been a while since I heard a break that hard. That I was like, yo, I gotta have that.
Yo, what's the break on the Dolly Parton record? This is a Dolly Parton drum break.
I don't got that.
Dolly Parton or Kenny Rogers?
No, it's Dolly Parton.
It's Kenny Rogers too, but I don't know about the Dolly joint, to be honest with you. I haven't heard about that drum break.
So all the bottom shelves are like breaks, right?
Yeah, the whole bottom shelves are breaks, all of it. In case anybody was wondering.
What's the Man Bites Dog roster? I know y'all got AG, y'all just signed AG the Coroner.
Yeah, Coroner's on there. Brock Marciano. Jason Rose, who's a genius, by the way. Look out for Jason Rose. He's going to change the world. Whole bunch of cats, man. Whole bunch of cats. I can't think right now. Who else? A Copyright, of course. Some other cats. Hayes. Shouts out to Hayes. CT. All the creeps. Soat. And, yeah, it's a whole bunch of other cats, too, man. Eddie B. Eddie B and Harry Frog got a project coming, too. And, okay. Yeah, that is just a little something that's coming in the end of the year, before the year is over.
Is there going to be, like, a another Weatherman project?
Weatherman?
Yeah.
Oh, with Copy?
Yeah.
I don't know, man. I don't think so. I don't think that's happening. I miss them days, too, man. Weatherman.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think he had an interview with Dan Hip Hop about that, and they asked him the same question, but I don't know, man. I don't think it's happening. Hopefully so. Hopefully, please, guys, please make a Weatherman compilation or something like that, you know, but I doubt it, man, but never know. Maybe.
You know what I miss, man? I miss Eastern Conference Records.
Me too, man.
They put out some good shit.
Yeah, with Jay Notes, and I mean, not Jay, Jay Zone.
Yeah. But even the, not the Smut Peddlers, but,
Smut Peddlers.
Mighty Hell, what was it?
Mighty My.
Mighty My and Mr. Eon.
Mr. Eon, yeah. I mean, Mighty My did most of the beats for those compilations, man. So, yeah, man.
That was a dope independent label.
I don't know. Eastern Conference, right? They were on the Ruckus, I think, right? They were like an imprint on the Ruckus, I believe.
I think they were by themselves.
Were they?
On Ruckus.
Oh, they were?
Yeah, I think
oh,
so.
Oh, okay.
I think they were. But, yeah, man.
Like back in the 90s, man, it was another joint in California. I think it was called something Boogie. Science Boogie? I can't remember. But
Ill Boogie.
Huh?
Ill Boogie. Ill Boogie Records?
It might have been Ill Boogie.
Like 12 inches.
Yeah, yeah. 90s had a bunch of dope indie labels.
Definitely.
Def Jux.
Def Jux, yeah. That Dead Ringer album is classic. RJD too.
Yeah.
I love that one.
What was the other white guy that used to be on Eastern Conference?
Cage,
yeah.
Oh, Cage, yeah. Movies for the Blind?
Yes.
Underground classic right there, man. Love that.
He's probably doing rock and roll now.
Yeah, he's doing a little bit of everything, but he's going back to his old roots too. I know that. I know
really?
A few tracks, yeah. Really dark. But he's doing a little bit of dubstep too. I don't know how people feel about dubstep, but how do you feel about dubstep?
He's rhyming over it?
Yeah, he's rapping over it. It's cool. I like dubstep. At first, I was like, nah, but it grew on me a little bit, you know?
Like, I don't know the difference between dubstep and EDM and house. Like, trance. I don't know the difference.
I guess dubstep is a little more electronic and, like, has a little influence of, like, reggae and dub just a little bit. But it's just very, like, it's electronic. And they all, it's like, I guess, like, the format of the song is all very familiar, you know. They always have the crazy breakdown. And, one of my boys was like, dubstep sounds like a whole bunch of robots fornicating. You know what I'm saying? So we said that. I was like, yo.
That's funny.
It still sounds, some of it just still sounds dope, man. Just gotta, you know, gotta find the good gems.
That's what everything.
Yeah.
So.
Well, that's a good one right there.
Yeah, I know, that's what I'm about to rock that out. Mm-hmm. See, folks, we don't just provide you with musical knowledge. We also have guest appearances as well.
That's right.
Fill you in on the latest music and the latest news.
Hec Dolo's shirt is sponsored by Karma Loop. And he has the matching dunks.
Unfortunately, sneakerhead habit.
Mm-hmm.
So do all your, you have shoes to match all your t-shirts?
Sadly, but yes.
See, I'm the way with fitteds and caps. Like, I have a cap to match everything that I have.
T-shirts, dunks, and t-shirts to go with them. So. All right, so let's rock with this.
Hold that record up again.
If you know about it, you know it's dope. If you don't, then this will be a treat for you. I don't even need to tell you who used it or any of that. Yeah, we'll figure it out.
Name two.
Black Sheep. Tribe.
I know it's Tribe too. What song was off Tribe? What song?
The one with Busta Rhymes.
Well, shit, that's 10 songs right there.
Versus yeah. In the abstract.
The song Black with Busta.
Yeah, I know which one you're talking about though. Yeah, I remember that. Like he looped it, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Did a Ron Carter bass on top. Mm-hmm. Rocked it out.
That's a Q-Tip production?
Q-Tip production off of Low End Theory.
Yo, did I tell you I was in this... I was at Young Guru's crib a couple weeks ago. Mm-hmm. And he replayed the Mobb Deep. He redid the Mobb Deep Shook Ones.
Really?
With like, exact same sample.
The one, the Herbie Hancock joint? The Fat Rotunda? Or...
No.
The guitar joint. There's two samples for Shook Ones.
Okay.
One of them is
the they all come from the same record.
Okay.
They all come from the same record.
What record was it?
I'll turn the camera off and tell you what it is. Another classic.
I can't remember what song it is right off the break, so bear with me. But it starts at the beginning, so... Talking about them.
For the people that don't know, kick the knowledge.
Mobb Deep, the Danny, Take Me Away joint, off of the classic.
But they slowed it way down.
Mm-hmm.
Slow it down. Well, slow it down on you.
Did the production.
Tip probably has more ghost production than we know about. Thanks, Hec, for another classic needle dropping. I have that record too.
Awesome record. If you don't got it, find it. It might be a little hard to find nowadays. I used to see them often back in the day, but nowadays, not so much.
I'm tripping over this Lost Scrolls because I've never seen this before. You think there's any more left?
I don't know, I gotta talk to my man from the foundation, so he's the one that hit me off with them.
Really?
Yeah. it handles pretty much all the merch right now, so.
Yeah, the, I need that.
With the joint, hit me off with the shirt. Got the little,
Hey, when are we supposed to get shirts? When are we supposed to get I Love Dilla's t-shirts, like, a year ago?
Dilla button.
He gonna come show us.
I know, man. Don't show me no shit. Oh, shit.
Yeah. Dilla apparel. I got to talk to him about the shirts. My bad. I forgot. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah.
But I'll talk to him. Because he's got pretty much all.
Alright. We out from Hec's crib. Another dope episode of...
Peace.
Needle dropping.
With Ciroc. We going back to work. So...
We gonna be at Ciroc's crib in a couple weeks.
Very soon.
Yeah. And this man over here.
Man, if you put this fucking camera on my face.